know what to do. And I went home and have lunch. I was going back to school and I was like, I do not know what to write the P. And one man came to my head and said, ask your mama, maybe she know. And I was like, ah, let me ask mama. Mama, you know what, I have to write this P for the teacher and I don't know what to write it. And she was like, let me see what you're writing. But I was writing the P backwards, I was writing a 9. And she was washing some clothes and she was, oh, you do it like this. And she got a piece of stick, and she write on the ground like this. And she make a stroke and she put it like this. She said, let's do it like this. Don't do this way, do this this way. And I was like, OMG, thank you, mama. You know, and that was so quick and magnificent for me because I didn't realize how easy it was because I didn't have the ability to even figure out what to do. And my mama gave me the strength to do that, you know, so and I appreciate her for that. My mom was always teaching me about life lessons and how to forgive and love people. And because my mom was a Christian lady, you know, and she went to church and she brought us to church, teach us about God. And that's why I'm so close to God today because of her teachings, you know. And she another time, she another episode I can give you is when I was about 11 years old now, when we moved into this new community and we didn't have no water and people used to like use pans to pails to catch water. But one day we was getting a pipe and all the neighborhood people was getting a pipe and we just came in the neighborhood, so they was giving us a little small tiny pipe. I was like, that's what you deserve. You know, and my mama was like, and we was like, no, mom, we don't want that much. But it's okay, let's take it. And, you know, it's all right. And everybody has got a big pipe in the neighborhood, and we had this little small pipe at the end. But something happened one day, like a miracle, because the water started running low, and everybody's water pressure went down. And guess who had water? Only we had water. So everybody in the neighborhood was coming to my gate, knocking, Miss P, can I have some water? I was like, I closed the gate. I was like, no, nobody's coming in. That's it. You know, there came my mama again. She was like, no, let open the gate and let the people in. Let them come in. It's okay. And I was like, mama, those people are the same people cursing us a couple of years ago and telling us that we're not going to get no pipe or we're never going to have no water. And now look at them coming in our house and our yard for water. Don't give them no water, mama. Mama was, no, you have to learn to forgive. Let them in and come in. And I was upset, though, you know. But I learned, like, after a while, years it took me, like, my mom had taught me to learn to forgive. And learn to love people, because sometimes people do things and they don't realize that what you do today can cost you tomorrow. But she taught me to forgive people and love people, and I appreciate and love my mother for that very much. And I wrote her a poem. This poem was written in 1995 when I was in Massachusetts, and a voice came to me and told me to write about my mother, which I had never done ever in my life. And it was all about myself, you know? So this time I chose to write about my mother, and I wrote this poem. It's called, My Mother is a Queen. My mother is a queen, I can see it in her eyes. My mother is a queen, I hope she never dies. My mother is a queen, she is from long ago. My mother is a queen, Haile Selassie I know. Mama is an African, taken from her home, taken to a land unto which she is unknown. The Most High promised her inheritance that she should inherit this earth. And now she's old and gray, still wondering what her life is worth. Mama always tell me, son, never disrespect your father. Mama always tell me, time is the greatest master. Mama gave I the courage to do the things I could not do. Mama is the purpose of my confidence and my inner strength. She could tell me the meaning of any word without consulting the dictionary. She would teach me many life lessons as a child, which would become important and useful to I as I grow. And I say, hey mama, you shall live forever. And Jah knows what I mean. With love, blessing and honor, my mama, the greatest human being. And I have another poem which I have to read. This. I want to read this one for my mother. It's called Nirvana. It's a phantom poem, and Mona gave me the intelligence and the knowledge to write this poem. Thank you, Mona. This is a phantom poem, it's different by Rasnik, because I wrote this poem last February. It's called Nirvana. I rise in my vision, I rise in my dream. Life is the book that has been written. Great were kings, great was oxen, up, up through the clouds in the heavens. Life is the book that has been written with dominion rules for us to go and come after. Ascending, I afloat through the heavenly clouds, feeling the might and triumph and power. With dominant rules for us to go and come after, the scorching sun now becomes a patient moon. I felt the might of triumph and power. Look, look, look upon me, zeal. A scorching sun has become the patient moon. I have seen her glory. I have seen her beauty. Look, look up upon me, zeal. My light, my crown, my angels. I have seen her glory. I have seen her beauty. Gazing, grazing at the universe's galaxy. My light, my crown, my angel. A spiritual triumph over the grave. Gazing, grazing at the universe's galaxy. Lost in the deep silence of this stationary moment, a spiritual triumph over death and the grave. I conquered my determination by staying focused. By staying focused. Lost in the deep silence of this stationary moment. Great were the kings, great were the king of Aksum. I conquered my determination, but I stayed focused. I rise in my vision, I rise in my dream. Thank you very much. Bless you.